Sebastian was headed south to Granada to find out more about his mother. He and Belle fell into a situation far worse than their wildest dreams.
So, it really is you, Jolly. Jolly, I demand you come to me.
I think you're mistaking this dog for someone else. This dog's name is Belle, not Jolly.
That's Jolly, and you're a liar. That dog is Jolly.
But that's impossible! This dog really belongs to me!
Raymond claimed to be Belle's original owner, and Sebastian agreed to work the problem out with him. But he wasn't prepared for what followed. Belle was caged, and when Sebastian snuck out for a nighttime visit, Belle wouldn't even look at him.
Grandfather, Belle has changed, and I don't know what to do. Poochie, this is the worst thing that ever happened to me.
Raymond and Boris hatch a devilish plan. Belle will be retrained to act as the white monster on command. She'll be forced to aid them in their life of crime. But their plan won't work with Sebastian in the way, so Boris makes a telephone call on the sly and reports Sebastian to the police. Sebastian is still thinking about Belle and his terrifying nightmare.
Sebastian, you have to be very careful.
Huh?
I have a feeling the police are coming to look for the white monster. Someone else who knows about the white monster must have seen the two of you and reported you to the police. But I wouldn't worry about this if I were you. I'll send anyone away who comes looking for you. But I would suggest not going out of the house for the time being. Good afternoon, officer. Is there anything I can do for you today?
This is terrible. I've got to go find Belle and warn her.
Listen, I won't be using words from now on. Instead, I'll be using signals. This one means lie down. And this signal means I want you to attack. Understand? Okay, let's try it. Lie down. You lie down, Jolly. All right, now follow my next command. Attack!
Belle! Stop it, Belle!
Don't disturb us!
You shouldn't be doing that. Why are you doing something awful like that? You'll become a real white monster if you keep on doing this. Why are you training Belle to do such horrible things?
I'm afraid that's none of your business.
Yes, it is my business. I made a promise with Mr. Boris to stay away because he said it would be for her own good. Well, Belle has changed all because of the way you're treating her.
It is my right to train Jolly the way I think best, and that's the way I trained her before.
Raymond. I think Sebastian also has the right to decide what's best. Perhaps it would be good if you just stopped today's training for the time being.
What are you saying? I was just getting someplace, and the dog was beginning to behave as she did before. You can't interrupt my training. Make sure this runt doesn't get away with anything.
I'm sorry, Sebastian. I hope you don't blame me for all this. I never imagined that Raymond intended to put Belle through such a cruel training program.
Thanks. Belle seems to be changing so much, and I don't understand it. I'm really worried.
All right. I'll tell Raymond how worried you are and give him a little warning. I'll tell you what. Why don't you take Belle for a while and have some fun playing?
Really? Can I?
Absolutely. Except only on the condition you don't wander from the house. We wouldn't want the police to find out that the white monster is staying here, would we?
Sure.
Good.
Hey, Belle. Poor girl. I promise never to let Raymond lay a hand on you ever again. Hey, Belle, let's go play.
It is difficult to make Belle concentrate if Sebastian is still here in such a big influence.
I know that. My plan is to get Sebastian away from this house as soon as possible by sending him on a wild goose chase. But before I can do that, I have to make Sebastian trust and believe me as a father.
We've got to get away from here, Belle. Nobody's watching, so we can escape from here right now and start looking for my mother again. Come on, let's go. Huh? Mr. Boris!
Ah, Sebastian, I have such wonderful news for you.
What?
Didn't you mention to me that your mother is a member of the Carlos Theater Company?
Yes, she is.
Then you are one very lucky boy. Because they're performing in a town only about 50 miles away from here.
Really? You found out where my mother is?
Mm-hmm. I wrote it all down on this piece of paper. I was told that the Carlos Company is now playing at a place called the Castillo Theater.
They're performing at the Castillo Theater?
Except their stay there will be finished soon, and they'll be leaving town, so I recommend you leave at once.
Castillo Theater. What? Then I'll never be able to make it there in time.
Don't you worry about a thing. You can get there easily in about half a day if you use my car.
Use your car?
I wish I could take you there myself, but I'm awfully busy right now. I'll just have my driver take you there.
Thank you so much, Mr. Boris.
Don't mention it. Any nice person would do the same thing for you.
Ah, but what should I do about Belle?
The police are on the lookout now, and I'd hate to have you arrested, so I don't see how you can possibly take Belle along with you.
But I'm so worried about leaving her here.
Don't worry. I'll take full charge of her. You can depend on me that no harm will come to your dog.
Ah, great! Did you hear the good news, Belle? I think I finally found my mother. Isn't that great? And then I'll talk to my mother and ask her to buy you back from Raymond. So you stay right here until I come back to get you, all right? Right.
Do you still have the slip of paper that I wrote the theater's name and address on?
Yes.
Well, take good care of yourself, Sebastian.
Thank you once again, Mr. Boris. Hey, Belle, I'll be back real soon with my mother to pick you up. If we drive in the car, I can be back here first thing tomorrow morning. Is that all right, Mr. Boris?
Oh, sure. That sounds fine to me.
Oh, Belle, everything will be all right. Mr. Boris will take care of you.
We'll wait here together for Sebastian to come back, won't we? Well, she's just upset because you're leaving her. But don't worry. I'll take good care of her. Now you better go so you can catch up with your mother.
Okay. Excuse me, Mr. Boris.
You are,
Remember, you told me that you wouldn't let Raymond go near Belle while I was gone. Promise me that, okay?
It's all right, I promise.
You'll be fine now, Belle. Don't you worry. You'll wait for me here, okay, Belle?
You understand my orders, don't you?
I understand them perfectly, sir.
Mr. Boris, please remember what you promised me, all right?
Mm-hmm.
You wait right here for me, Belle.
Hmm?
No, Belle, you can't come with me now.
Hold it.
I'll be back for you soon. Bye, Belle.
This is a doll. When I give you the order, you will attack right over here. Lie down. Good work. You must attack. You must bite. Attack only in this area. Don't even let it cross your mind to disobey me. This is what you'll get if you disobey me. Understand me? Understand each other. Now you get back there. All right. We're going to start from the beginning again. You'll keep repeating it until you get it right. Oh, you did it wrong again. Get back there.
Well, this is the place. Go right up that alley and you won't be able to miss it.
Is this the right address?
This is it. Just turn right at the end of that alley and you'll bump into the Castillo Theater.
Thank you very much. Well, let's go.
You shouldn't be in here. It's very dangerous because of all the falling stones.
You really scared me. But tell me, isn't this place supposed to be the Castillo Theater?
Huh? You're looking for the Castillo Theater?
Well, actually, I came here looking for my mother. I was told by someone that I could find her at the Castillo Theater, and then he wrote down the address.
Hmm. Well, Castillo means a castle in Spanish, and this is the only castle in town. But there's no theater in here.
What?
The person who gave you this information must have been lying to you. But why would anyone ever want to tell you such a terrible lie?
Oh.
Huh?
Car is already gone. He was lying to me all the way. We've got to go back, Pucci. Belle must be in a lot of trouble.
Raymond's brutal training methods are effective. Sebastian runs as fast as he can, knowing that he must get back to save Belle. When night falls, he hasn't given up and is still running.
Oh. I have to hurry. I must get back quickly. Belle is in danger.
She's a very smart dog. She mastered the trick as soon as the boy had gone away.
Okay, so let's agree that we're going to do it tomorrow.
I hope nothing terrible has happened to Belle while I was gone.
What's Miss Julie up to now?
She's out taking her morning walk.
Thank you. It's an emergency. I'll follow you, Pucci.
I can't believe.
I'd go bankrupt if I didn't get this house, so I really had no choice in the matter. Even my life was in danger. But you will die if you don't sell your house.
Attack, Jolly. Follow my orders.
No, Belle, this man wants to hurt us. You have to protect us from them.
I can't believe it. You're really going to disobey my orders. Jolly, you do as I tell you. I'll show you that you have to obey. I won't leave you alone. Listen to me!
Ah!
Sebastian, help, help, help.
Oh. Belle!
Thank you for saving my life, Sebastian. Belle, and you too, little Poochie.
It's truly unbelievable. That dog followed the boy's orders with just a simple call, and there was nothing I could do to make her listen to me.
Miss Julia, we ran as soon as we heard the noise. What happened?
Sebastian, Belle, and Poochie protected me from two men who tried to kill me.
Huh? Oh?
It wasn't us, Inspector. We didn't do anything. It was really the white monster who came and attacked us.
Be quiet. Now take them away.
Yes, sir.
No, it was the white monster, I tell you.
By the way, is it true that the white monster was spotted around this area?
Well, I've never seen a white dog near my home since I've lived here.
That's right. We absolutely hate dogs, so we'd have reported it to you immediately if we saw an animal like that.
I'm glad to know the truth. I'll deal with those two liars.
Thank you for all your help.
Just keep going in that direction, and you can go very far south without anyone catching sight of you at all.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Mm-hmm. Now remember, now don't you ever get yourself separated from Belle again.
Mm-hmm. I've been thinking a little bit about Belle and her last owner.
I'll tell you something. There's a very simple way of looking at this problem, and I hope I can give you some good advice. I spend lots of time with the living things in the garden, and you'd be surprised how much the way a plant works can tell you about how people work. I believe it's important that flower be watered and fed by a person who can bring it lots of love. And that's not necessarily the person who planted the seed. And I think that's the way it is with you and Belle, Sebastian. And that's the way it should be. It makes a lot of sense that you're together. After all, who can give you more love than your very best friend?
Yay! Belle and I, hooray! Belle and Sebastian, we're best friends! Yeah. Goodbye. Thank you very much.
Mm-hmm.
Come on, Belle, let's go.
In the last few days, Sebastian had learned all about Belle's unhappy past. But most of all, he'd learned about friendship. Sebastian now understood that true friendship cannot involve ownership. He, Belle, and Poochie shared the best kind of friendship, a friendship based on love and mutual respect. And that meant that they'd be friends forever.